morning, guys. Welcome back. Joined here with Mr. Gus. We've just been having a really slow morning. Feel like we really needed it, didn't we, Gus? It's actually not morning, it's actually 20 to 12. Yeah, I actually really wanted to have a chat with you guys when I got back from Paris, but sadly, I got back on Monday night, and by Tuesday, I was, let's just say, both ends were not happy. So I'm pretty sure it was food poisoning. The last thing I ate in Paris was some mussels in Soho House. So I'm guessing it was that, but yeah, Tuesday I was completely out of it. And then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, I've just been trying to frantically catch up with work. So yeah, this week has just been like trying to catch up on everything. And as a result, I'm just feeling really drained. I'm really not feeling myself. I'm just really run down, I think. I think the past few weeks, like all of February, February just flew by for me. Like the past few weeks, I've just been so on the go. I haven't really had much time to myself, which I feel like is so vital for me. That's what I'm starting to learn now. Like this time on my own, like these weekends where Alex is away and it's just Gus and I, and we're pottering around the house, getting jobs done. So vital for me. I think with work and my career just being so busy at the moment, which obviously I love, but it's really important for me to have these weekends where I'm just chilled. I also got a really lovely gift in Paris, which I picked up from the Cartier store, which you would have seen. So I'm gonna go and hop in the bath, have a really like relaxing bath, have a little pamper. I actually got my nails done the other day, which were really overdue. Can you see? I went for like this short, milky pink, creamy kind of polish, and I love it. I said to her, I said, I want Kim K nails. Hey, Baba. Hey, Baba. You saying hi to the vlog? It's been a while since you've said hi to the vlog, isn't it? He's loving this chill morning. This is Gus's idea of heaven, just relaxing in bed all morning with his mummy. You love it, don't you? Should we go and get in the bath? We got it. Really needed that. A daytime bath, and then I've got straight back into some clean pajamas. These ones are from Beauty Pie, and they are so soft, and they actually fit me as well. You can't see the length, but because I'm so tall, usually pajamas are like short weekends on me, but these actually touch the floor and I love them. They're absolutely perfect for a day like today. I'm trying to find a reusable cotton pad because I've run out of cotton pads and I need to apply my toner. I don't have any. I used to have some. That's annoying. Okay, we can use this muslin cloth. But yeah, I just really needed a day like today. This is like my idea of a dream day. Bath in the afternoon, straight back into some clean pajamas. Yeah, I just need a day at home. Even though I don't know how Gus is going to let me get away with that. Hope you guys are enjoying this new light I've got. I mentioned it in the Paris vlog. It's like a little Amazon light. I just feel like it's perfect for vlogging and just out and about with your phone. I forgot to say, I've also got in this scented scalp oil. Now, scented is one of my clients I work with. And their en route scalp oil is incredible. So everyone's hair oiling is what you call it at the moment. Like scalp care is huge, isn't it? But this scalp care in particular, it's got rosemary oil, which is really big at the moment. And it's also got lots of other oils like tea tree. I feel like I should know this. It's got tea tree, flower oil, It's basically got like so many incredible ingredients for the scalp. Now I've just put this in now because I'm going to wash my hair tomorrow. So I usually put it in, if I can, leave it for a day and then wash it off the next day. And since I've been using it, I went to the hairdressers last week for a blow dry before I went to Paris. And she said to me, she said, you've got so much new growth coming. Like all these little bits at the front that are like sticking up. And she said like in my hair as well, I had just like loads of little tiny strands of hair. She was like, by summer you should have like a lot of thickness. And I'm sure, I've been taking the My Vitamin hair skin and nails gummies, but I'm sure it's from using this as well. So I'll keep you posted on how I'm getting on with it, but I absolutely love this brand. I've been using it for ages and I really do feel like since I've been using it, the thickness of my hair has just dramatically improved. So yeah, I've got this in today as well. So like I say, Self-Care Saturday is officially in full flow. Oh, that toy is really stinking gross. Can we put it in the bin, please? It's really gross, Gussie. I really don't want to play with it with you. Here we go. I think I'm going to have to go out. I think I'm going to have to take him out. Just put my Adenola jumper on. I just had to nip down and get some. I did a GoPuff order. It's fabulous GoPuff, you know, I must say. You know, you're just having one of those days where you can't be bothered to go out into the world. Pretty much does anything. It's a bit pricey, but it's the trick. Got myself some fish fingers. I'm going to make myself a fish finger sarnie for lunch. Can't go wrong with a fish finger sarnie. I haven't had one in ages. I was like, you know what I'm craving? Good old fashioned fish finger sarnie. Some nice soft bread, seeded bread. Bit of mayo, bit of salad. Can't go wrong. Just don't know how many fish fingers to have. Did you get 8 in the packet? Should I do 3 or 4? What do you guys think? How many do you usually go for? 3 or 4? That is a question. Sod it, I'm going for 4. I am going for 4. Going all out. Self-care Saturday. Pop them in the air fryer. How long should I put them in for? I think 10 minutes will do the trick. I'm going to wait until I finish speaking to you to put it on. And then I just, stop. I didn't press that then, you know. I swear, I did not. This is very sensitive. And then I just got myself one of the Trip CBD drinks. I had one yesterday for Barry's. Honestly, I felt out of it. I was like running and my legs were like jelly. I have one of those. And then I got some sunflower seeds just because I know if I got some feta, because I saw a recipe on Instagram that I want to try tomorrow for breakfast. It was like rye bread with avocado. Oh! I swear I ordered avocados. It looks like I'm not doing that recipe then because I need avocados. I need avos. Did I order them? Let's see. Let's see. If they forgot my avos and I actually ordered them, I'm going to be cross. Because I was really looking forward to that. Yeah, I did order avos. Oh, what do you do? What do you do? Right, there's a chat support. Hopefully they can drop my avos. But yeah. That's it, basically. That's all I wanted to tell you. I'm gonna try and get my avos because I wanna do avocado on rye bread with feta and sunflower seeds for breakfast tomorrow before I go to yoga. So that's why I wanted my avocados. Fruit, vegetables. Check even one of the items might be out of stock, I'll let you know. Oh, it said one of the items might be out of stock. Let's have a look. No, they didn't mention anything about out of stock items in my email. Please fill out this form. Oh, don't you hate a form? Just give me my flipping avocados. Anyway, and then also look what else had arrived. Pukka teas from Amazon. This is such a good deal. If you drink Pukka teas, get them from Amazon because this was £13. I'll link them down below, and you get four boxes. Whereas in the shops, I feel like they're usually like £3-4 for one box. And I love these boxes. Let me try and open them, because you get a selection of different ones. So you get the, they're like all my favourite ones as well. So you get the nighttime tea, which I swear by. I've been drinking that for years, and it is the best. It really does like ease you into a nice sleep. Ooh. So you get the nighttime tea, the three mint tea, the feel new, which is like, I think it's got like fennel in it or something, but it's nice. It's like de-bloating. And then you get the lemon, ginger, and macuna honey, and the elderberry and echinacea. And echinacea, did you know, is amazing for building your immune system. So this time of year, I like to make sure that I'm drinking the echinacea tea in particular. So yeah, and you get them all, and then I just put them away, stash them away, and this usually lasts me like a month. So yeah, look at these. Let me show you the box, just in case you're interested. Also, I am procrastinating tidying the room a bit, I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna lie, guys. What I've been doing is just getting through this Paris vlog, because there is so much footage. Me and Lauren just went a bit ham with it, to be honest. We got a bit excited. So there's a lot of footage that needs to be edited. Made the best fish finger sandwich. I'm so excited. I even made myself a matcha. Put some strawberries in it as well, some frozen strawberries. Use my milk frother as well. How good it looks. Like, you would pay good money for that, wouldn't you? Now for the sandwich. Put mayo and lettuce in. Fish finger sandwich is just an elite lunch. That's good. Lots of mayo. I did not hold back on the mayo. Soft bread, lure pack, fish fingers, got the Hellman's mayo, excuse me, romaine lettuce, it's just the one.
No, good boy, there we go.
Woman on Instagram called again? With Somerset Blooms reached out to me, and she was like, I absolutely love your page. Can I send you some flowers? I was like, how sweet. What is better than some cream? I'm actually going to show you properly. I need to show you these properly. Of course. How gorgeous are they? Cream roses with eucalyptus. They are so me. And I needed some flowers as well, because I usually have some flowers here next to the sink. Oh, can't wait to put those in a vase. I'm just overwhelmed. How gorgeous are they? How gorgeous, guys. I can't believe it. Thank you so much, Somerset Blooms. Nat. Nat was the lovely lady's name. She's absolutely adorable. Guys, look, I've just arranged them. Well, I didn't need to arrange them because they were already arranged, but I've just put them in a vase. I'm in love. I am literally in love.
So whilst I'm just sat here, I was just about to put Angus Thongs and Perfect Snogging on, because don't know why, but I've just been wanting to watch that film for so long. I feel like it's just the perfect cozy Saturday nostalgic film to watch. I'm gonna put that on in a bit. But I've been dying to show you guys what I've got in Paris. So, as you would have seen, we went to the Cartier store. They're just Cartier. How pretty is it? This is like such an emotional gift for me. So, bit of a backstory, well, not a backstory. Basically, Alex has bought me this for my birthday. He said to me, he said, if you see anything in Paris that you really like, let me know and I'll get it you for your birthday. So when I told him, he knows that I've wanted what's in this box for a while. So when we went in there and I tried them on, he was like, go for it. So it's just so meaningful. Alex and I, if you don't know, we've been together for almost 8 years. And I feel like we've just come so far together. Like, we really have. Like, I couldn't have even imagined we'd be where we are now. And not in a negative way, but I just feel like I'm really proud of us, basically. So I just feel like this is such a meaningful, like, milestone gift for us. Well, for me. But he gets to see it as well. So yeah. So this is the red Cartier box, which is just an absolute iconic. It's just an iconic box, isn't it? And then you open it here. I must say, I'm a bit disappointed with the quality. Oh no, it's supposed to come down. Because I was gonna say I was disappointed with the quality of the box because it was like coming away here, but it's supposed to come down like this. And then obviously you've got, this is the iconic box actually. The outer box, that can stay. But how beautiful is that? Such a beautiful quality box. And then, Gus is playing with his toy. Gus, I don't want to play with that toy though because it's dirty. Can we get an... I'm chucking that toy away. That's disgusting. And then... there she is. The little love ring. Beautiful. I love this ring because I feel like it's so understated. Sorry guys, wait there. Like I was saying before Gus rudely interrupted, I just love this ring because it's just so me. Like, I'm not really into, I mean, don't get me wrong, if someone bought me diamonds, I'm not going to be like taken back. But I don't know, I feel like I'm much more of like a minimal, understated girl. And I just think this is such an iconic style. It's so timeless, it doesn't age. And it's just, I just absolutely love it. I just know that I'm going to have this forever. I'm going to wear it every day. Gussie, sorry guys. So yeah, I just love it. And it just, like I say, it's not even, it's more special than any other gift I've ever received because it's from Alex. So I am very happy with this. Let me try it on for you. And they actually have an engraving service at Cartier, but the machine was broken in the Paris store. So Alex is actually gonna take this to the Bond Street store next time he's in London and get it engraved. So he's gonna get his initials, but don't laugh, because his initials are AGT, which is Alex Gus Teagan. And I feel like, as well, that's really meaningful because this is just like a point of our lives that, you know, I don't mean to be morbid, but Gus isn't gonna be with us forever. And I feel like it's just such a beautiful, special, happy time in our life that, I don't know, I just feel like, oh my god, I'm gonna get emotional. Oh, but yeah, I just feel like that's just really special for us. So yeah, I'm gonna wear it on this finger. I feel like I probably could have got the size down. However, when my fingers are warm or hot, they swell up. So I didn't want to risk not being able to wear it when my hands are warm, which is basically all of summer. So it's still, I mean, to be fair, it is loose, but I feel like it'll be fine. So yeah, here it is. Can you see it? Just very simple, very me. And quite frankly, I'm in love. And you also get it with this little... you get it with this little pouch as well. So when you're traveling, you can, if you want to keep it safe, you've got this little pouch as well. which I thought was really cute.
Here again, I'm just making my vegetable chili. I thought I'd tell you what I do. So basically what I do is I blend mushrooms and peppers in my little hand blender, and everything just goes almost like, not a pulp, but like really small. And then I mix it with garlic, onions, fresh chili, and then I use corn mince, but the mushroom just gives it like a real meatiness and makes it taste like normal meat. Obviously it's not. Yeah, I'm just making that now. It's one of my favourite things to cook, actually. My vegetable chili. Well, it's not vegetable chili. Oh no, I've just dropped it on the floor. I didn't know it was open, the bag. Oh no, Gus. Oh no!
Got Angus thongs and perfect snogging on in the background. Alright.
Classic film. So yeah, I love this chili. It's like a solid, like one of my, it's like one of those meals that I cook quite a lot, especially when I feel like I need a nutrition boost, which I really feel like I need. I feel really run down, actually. Touch wood, it's something serious. Hopefully it just goes on its own. I think it's just tiredness. So yeah, and then I've put the corn mince in, and then tomatoes. I've got this sachet of chili mix, just because I feel like it tastes better than when you just add all the spices willy-nilly. And then I've got some black beans to go in as well. And then I'll just simmer it and just let it cook for like a good hour so all the flavours get a chance to marinade. And then just to make my life easy, because I'm on my own tonight, I've got this, which is like the microwave rice and quinoa. Nice, easy, simple dinner tonight. Nice and nutritious, just what I need. Yesterday, so he really needs one today. But he's still in bed. He's a lazy boy, Gus, you know. He literally is happy to stay in bed till midday if you let him. Aren't you, Gus? You're happy to lie in bed all bloody morning. You've got to get up. It's currently, what time is it? It's currently 9:30. And that's really early for Gus, trust me. I usually just let him stay in bed until about 10, to be honest. So yeah, I'm looking forward to it. We're doing Bikram yoga today, which I haven't done for years. It's like the hot sweaty yoga. So I'm looking forward to that. Wait, I just want to go and get my beauty pie mask. So you've got the Japan Fusion. I think I showed it to you the other day when I was in the bath. It's their Bioceramide Moisture Mask. And I thought it'd be quite nice because when I get back, I'm gonna have a shower and wash my hair. So I thought it'd be nice just to put a layer on now whilst I'm working out. Just to give me like a nice hydration. So I'm gonna put a bit of that on. But yeah, I just had such a nice chill night last night. Had my chili. What else? Watched Angus thongs, edited a bit more of the vlog, and you know what? I really needed it. Read my book. I've just finished it. It's called Mad Honey, and oh my days, guys, it's a bit of an emotional roller coaster, to be honest. And I must say, it's not one of those books where you get to the end and you're like, oh, okay. It's not like a happy, necessarily happy ending. It's kind of like bittersweet. Really great book though. It's got a lot of really sort of important social issues and things thrown in there as well. Just a really great read. It's a big book, don't get me wrong, but it's a good book, for inspiring in its own way, and I think everyone can kind of take something from it. So yeah, that was good. Oh, I forgot to tell you, I also tidied the spare room. I couldn't be bothered to film it because, you know what, it was already emotionally draining enough having to do it. So I was like, you know what, just don't think about it. Because you know when I'm actually doing it, I actually really enjoy it because I want that room to be tidy. I think I get in my head about it. So I tidied that room as well. Yeah, had an early night, and yeah, I'm feeling great today, to be honest. Looking forward to a nice yoga session, getting Gus out for some walkies, and then back here to just kind of do the same thing as I did yesterday, really. I'm enjoying it. I really feel like I needed this weekend to just ground myself again. You know, I feel like the next few weeks I've got a lot of work projects on, which I obviously want to make sure that I enjoy and am present for. So yeah, needed this. Before I nipped out, I just wanted to show you quickly what I just did because I forgot to film it. So I had my, as you know, I put my scented scalp oil on yesterday, so I've slept in that. And then before I go out to yoga, I thought I'd just put a mask at the ends. It's a super healthy hair beauty pie mask treatment. They sent me this a while ago. I don't know how I feel about it. I don't think it's my favourite mask, I'm not going to lie. Like, I don't really have noticeably amazing results after. But let's give it another try today. And I've just tied it up in a bun for yoga. Yeah, I thought I'd just make myself a quick smoothie. Yeah, I'm not that hungry this morning, but I feel like I'm going to need something if I'm going to have some energy for this class. I don't know what I'm going to put in it. I've got bananas. That's a start, isn't it?
I'm in a bit of a rush. Gus is still not out of bed. I'm like, come on, man. Get out of bed, Gussie.
Anyway, like I said, who's this? Voice note from Alex. Anyway, banana. What else have we got? What else? We're absolutely winging it. Sweet. Right, I really need to pick up the pace now because I need to be walking with Gus in about 10 minutes time. It's not like me to cut it fine, is it? Not like me to cut it fine. I'm being very sarcastic, guys. It's very much so like me to cut it fine. My timekeeping is one thing in my life that, as much as I try and improve it, it's bad. It's bad. It's very bad. That's all I'm saying. It's bad. Right, let's put some cashew nuts in, chia seeds. I don't really want protein powder in today. Oh, you know what I'm going to put in instead? Cacao. Got some cacao. What is better than cacao? We'll put a bit of cacao in it. Well, actually, I've got a really nice vegan protein powder that I could put in it. Just made a right mess there. That is annoying. That is annoying. Is that better? Right. Chia seeds. What else was I going to put in? Do we have time to put the protein in? 52. Morning, Gus! Oh, Gus is up now. Fabulous. So that means I can just get his lead on him, put my shoes on, and we can go. You ready, Gus? And then I've got this Anika. Yeah, Anika Superfoods. It's a vegan protein powder. It's fabulous. I really love it. So there we go. Cacao, banana, chia, cashews, frozen blueberries, banana, and then I'm going to put some oat milk in it. I'm going to just put a bit of oat milk in it. I'm going to do half oat milk, half water. I just feel like too much oat milk is a bit much sometimes. Oh, I actually might take this with me. Let's see. Sorry for the wonky angle, guys. I'm in a rush. Not, I want a really powerful one. A one that really makes some makeup on. Not makeup, but I wanted to just put a bit of concealer on, but I'm not gonna have time anymore. My priority is walking Gus, so let's get him out for a walk, and then if I've got time before I need to leave for yoga, and then that's a bonus, I suppose, isn't it? That's a bonus. So there we go. Morning smoothie. Yeah, I feel like that's what you get with a really good blender. Like, you get a really real liquid consistency. This is still a bit like, you know, it's really nice though. Right, let's skedaddle.
Gussie, come and show the vlog. You're all clean. Come and show everyone. Are you gonna come and say hi to everyone now? You're all clean. Come and show everyone how lovely and clean you look.
Oh, look. Look, he's showing you now.
Look. How fabulous do you look? All clean. Hey? So Gus and I have just had a bit of a pamper, really. I got back from yoga. I had to nip into a few shops just to get a few bits and bobs on the way back.
Yeah. And then I got back, I did a bit of a tidy up. And then we both got in the shower together. Oh, the recycling's just fallen over. Yeah, we both got in the shower together. So Gus, the easiest way to shower Gus is to put him in the shower. We've got like a shower cubicle thing with like a sliding door. And he loves it. He absolutely loves it. So yeah, yoga was lovely. Yoga was really nice. It was Bikram yoga, which I haven't done for a while, but it was really good. I sweated so much. And then I came back, had a nice shower. So, feeling super chilled. It's about 3 o'clock now. And I think I'm just going to take it easy. I've got a bit of the Paris vlog to finish editing. I want to get that out today. And apart from that, I'm just going to take it easy. This is like my perfect weekend. Just taking it easy, taking it slow. Making sure everyone's tidy, pampering myself, spending time with Gus. Yeah, I'm just feeling the Sunday vibes, guys. I really am. I just thought to myself, what can make today more perfect? A roast. My favourite place that does a roast in Liverpool, they deliver. And it's so lazy because I could go and collect it. It's literally like a 5 minute walk. But you know what? It's Sunday. Oh, let me show you. I went for lamb. Oh, I went for lamb. There's roast potatoes, there's parsnips. There's a Yorkshire pudding, and then I've got some
cauliflower cheese on the side.
Oh, look at that. This is such a treat. I've got lamb, I've got mac and cheese, even though I was supposed to order cauliflower cheese, I'm a bit gutted about that. Roast potatoes, the best Yorkshires ever, broccoli, parsnips, carrots, and the best gravy. Happy girl.